everyone. Welcome for the talk is Pentesting Best APIs. So this is my intro. I'm Nutan Kumar Panda, also known as the OCN guy. I'm a senior information security engineer in one of the biggest e-commerce. I'm a OCN enthusiast, presenter in many different conferences, author of one book, contributed to one cool project called Data Splat, and active contributor in Null Bandwidth chapter. So what can you expect in this talk? I will take you in a journey of basic queries. I don't want to waste time on queries. I have references in my talk. In the PPT itself, you can go there and check more detailed versions. And then I will talk about my personal experience, how I started REST API. When in those days when I do not have any resources and all, and the approach how to test REST API, what are the tools available, some of the older tools, some of the well-known tools, and one of the tools which got released just day before yesterday in AppSec USA, we are releasing it here, and what are the test beds available to test REST API, because most of the people, for SOAP there are many, but for REST there are very few. So I will take you through those things also. And one example to how to go for testing of a REST API, means what are the places you need to check and you need to do different things. Some common findings that I usually find, and some hands-on demos. This presentation will talk basically about my experience and my knowledge. So if there will be a point that I might be wrong, so feel free to correct me. And what not, do not expect any poor jokes in the presentation. I don't want to. So my long way with web services. It all started 2 years or 3 years back when I got a project of REST API. In that time, I was pretty good, doing good in SOAP services. I had written some of the articles, a chain of articles about how to test SOAP services but not REST. So when I got that project, I found in Google that there are not much well-documented things out there how to pen test a REST API. I didn't find any test beds in that time. So that was very difficult time for me to complete that project. Then I called some of my friends who already did REST API. They told me that they got some cool bugs in Oath Covert Open Redirect. I was like, what the hell is that? I didn't know. And when I got REST API, it was just an endpoint. So I didn't know what to do with the endpoint. I thought of the normal web application approach, like fuzzing different parameters, and it didn't help me. Now, as this is basically about the definition of SOAP versus REST. You can take it this way: SOAP is like kind of output, which is heavy, full of noises, like scraps, and REST API is like Facebook, clean, latest technology, and lightweighted. That's why people are moving to REST. Why REST is popular nowadays? Most of the web applications, mobile applications associated with that using this. Many of the services like AWS, they are also using REST. So it is very important nowadays. If you are into application security, you must know how to pen test a REST API. There are cool documentations provided. Like if you want to go for SOAP pen testing, there is a thing present there. And if you are into REST, go check this particular slide, RESTful Web Services Pen Testing by Mohammad Irfan, who is currently the Null Singapore mod. He's in Null Singapore. And when I talk about Oath, there are different kind of Oath services, and what are those? If you are interested in that, there is a slide by Bindya, I guess. You can check this Oath token. And if you want to know what else web services are there and how to test, there is a link provided below. This is by Praveen. He gave this presentation 2-3 months back here in Null Bangalore. And the phase 3 generally consists of what are the other web services that can be tested. So the story I said, how I started, like in that time there was no OWASP security, REST security checklist. So I had to prepared everything from scratch. The problems I faced is like when I went to web services, I knew of only one tool that is called SOAP UI. And when I went to SOAP UI, it asked for a WDL or WHDL file. I knew WHDL because SOAP services are associated with that. I have no idea with what WDL is, and I never got a project with a WDL file. So basically, the SOAP UI tool never worked for me to pentest a REST API because I never got the opportunity to test a WDL file. Then, like, I asked many people, it didn't work well, so I started my approach, and I will take you through that. First thing, the important thing is, it's not about just getting the endpoint. You need to ask different questions to your employer or your client. It depends on whether you are an in-house pen tester or security engineer, or you are working for some service-based industry and you have different clients' requirement of doing a pen test. What you need to do is, you need to ask different questions like, is there any documentation? The first thing, most of the REST APIs are well documented. If you ask a client about documentation, you will come to know that what are the endpoints, which protocol it is using, or method it is using, and based on that, you can use that to for depending. Let's say there is an example of something, one endpoint which is only accessible by GET. Can we do it by a post or delete, or can we use it by a post? Based on that, if you can able to change that and you are getting some results, that means method conversion bug is there. So similarly, documentation is very important. You need to ask for documentation. You need to ask for simple sample request and response. So many of the web services needed a particular set of data. Let's say there is a user ID. You didn't know the user ID value. What can be a user ID, valid user ID value? Without knowing that, you cannot fudge that parameter, because you have to know that what is a genuine request and what kind of values are provided in that. Based on that, you can fudge that and try to get more things. So a sample request response for a Postman collection. How many of you are aware of Postman collection? Okay, let me tell you. Postman is a tool or app which is like intercepting proxy or it does all kind of thing for REST APIs. So Postman collection is nothing but a sample request and response for a REST API. So you need to ask for that. You need to ask for particular headers, because in REST API, headers means a lot. All kind of authentications are done via headers nowadays. Like if you think about OAuth or something like that, there are like bearer authentication headers, which is a must. Without that, you cannot get authenticated to an endpoint and you cannot test that. So you need to ask a particular header requirement. Ask for any tokens or parameters or parameter value or everything, whatever. Because to get right into a flow, let me tell you, I'm working for e-com, so the general e-com process is like that. You go see a product, you add that product into cart. After adding that product into cart, you go and do a checkout, right? Let's say there is a bug in checkout. You cannot do that process directly hitting the checkout, because you need to buy a product, add that to the cart, then only this process will work like the checkout process. So you should have that idea of how to start the flow and end the flow, then only you can do different kind of fudging or injections in a REST API. So you ask those details. And it's not only about fudging the parameters. Why so? I will tell you in the latter slide. Let's jump into the tools which are available in public. One is REST Client. This is a plugin for any browser. Like it is available for Chrome and Mozilla. I'm using it in Mozilla. There is a Postman. Postman, it comes as a standalone app and also as a Chrome plugin. And the best part of Postman is that this is one of the most popular tools which is used, and this is based out of a startup of Bangalore. So you should be proud of that. There is another, we use Bob generally for interception proxy. You can use your own, or you can use Tampa data or HTTP Lite or whatever which you are feel too good to use. Like, you need any kind of interception proxy to intercept and do your work for you. There is hurl.it, which is an online app, web app. which is there in this domain, and you can directly do testing from that. But I must tell you, do not use that, because you are logging your client data or your own REST API data there. So it's advisable not to use any online thing. There is SOAP UI, and there is a video attached to this. If you want to go check how to do REST API testing using SOAP UI, you can definitely. And last one is one of the best, that is Fuzz API. This is a cool tool which is released in AppSec USA by Abhijit and Lalit. The slides are there, and I will demo everything, how to test REST API using Fuzz API. This is quite cool. You just add an endpoint and you have to hit, and it will do the work for you. And if you like this tool, feel free to tweet with Fuzz API, so that the contributors for the project person, they will get to you, you can send your feedbacks over there. What are the test beds available? The most popular and famous one is Hackajohn, that is by NTObjects, which is later acquired by Rapid7. The code, the web version, and the best part of this is there is an Android app associated with this particular project, so you can use that Android app. Generally, if you see other Android apps, generally Android apps are limited to local storage analysis, right? Whatever DEM vulnerable, means according to my knowledge, whatever DEM vulnerable Android applications are there, those are only limited to client-side attacks, not the server or dynamic analysis part. So this will help you to get your hands in dynamic analysis as well as doing the REST API thing. There is a cool demo video which starts on 24 minutes about how to set up Hackajohn, what it is all about. And the coolest part of Hackajohn is this is a simulated version of an e-com site, and which is workflow bounded. So as I told you earlier, you cannot do, there is a four step procedure. You cannot jump into third step and do injections and all. So you have to follow everything, and which is there in Hackajohn. Mutual Day, this is also one of the WASP projects, and the code is here and the video is here, how to do web services pen testing. Though I didn't quietly like of this, the web services part which is exported from Mutual Day is something like a normal GET request, because it comes with a question mark and a parameter, that's why. There is DEM vulnerable web services, which is the best option for SOAP UI testing. It has one challenge for REST API, and that is that looks quite genuine for a REST API thing, because it comes with resource and all. So you can check that also. Okay. Let's take an example of how a typical REST API endpoint looks like. It looks like something like this. REST API, the basic thing of REST API comes in four methods, like post, get, output, and delete. That is called CRUD, create, update, read, and delete. So we generally play between these four methods. So let's say this is an example, simple example. This is the URL or the domain name. This is the method it's gonna use. These parts are called resources, because this will give you the output based on that. So users know this is called a collection of resource, and these parameters are individual resource which will fetch resources for you. This is the post parameter or data for this particular endpoint. So now you guys tell me what kind of attacks possible in this particular example. How many different attacks we can launch in this particular example? One thing, we can search for different IDs, that's for sure. But don't you think that it will associated with this particular username and so? Privilege escalation.
There is no login.
I don't think so. Injection, yes, definitely injection is possible. Anything else? Deleting that user, that depends on whether this endpoint is...
Change post to put.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If that particular endpoint is using some other method like delete and put, we can add a user or delete a user.
Okay.
we need to check for that. Anything else?
Instead of view, then edit.
Yeah, but we have to keep that in mind that, see, this is the most important thing I want to talk. View means read, right? So if you want to change the view to edit or create or delete or update, or you want to fudge that parameter, you make sure that you will put associated methods with that. Like if you are using create here, try to put post or put. Put methods there. If you want to delete this user, put delete here and try a associated method there. So it is not just about fudging the parameter, it is also understanding what this function will do and what is the method available for that. So you have to keep that mind to test REST services. So
IDOR?
Definitely IDOR is the most what we can get from a REST API is people say IDOR. I take that as enumeration. Like you can enumerate lots of stuff by just fudging integer value or whichever parameter it looks like it can give you more data. Yeah, based on the endpoint, if you can enumerate more details about this endpoint, then definitely you can change the role. If you can create a user, definitely you can change the role. Any queries? Okay, if now you will get any kind of endpoint like this, now you have idea how to approach that endpoint and how to test different scenarios. Everyone is sleeping or?
Yes.
Okay. So the common findings that I usually find, one is enumeration, like people say IDOR, insecure type object references, where you will get more data about some other user than yours. Because generally, I have found many cases that the endpoints, the REST APIs, they do not have token, generally. So you can get this bug quite easily. Rate limiting, this is also a big issue in terms of REST APIs. It is a bit difficult to implement rate limiting there. So enumeration or brute forcing or doing a mass enumeration attack is quite possible in REST API because you cannot implement CAPTCHA kind of thing, right? This is a services, so you cannot implement CAPTCHA. You have to do an IP-based monitoring or blocking, something like that. Yeah, token means it is already authenticated. There is some kind of... CSRF token won't work here because this is not a typical kind of post or get. This is a back-end service. Those kind of token means, yeah, that can be used, or generally what people do is there is something called IAF token to validate authentic users. So generally they use that for authentication and validation, both purposes. So those token will work, but mostly you will find these two bugs. The third one is information disclosure. Like any web application, web services are also vulnerable to this. Method conversion, yes. If you get a documentation of REST API, you can try different methods, and most of the time you will find that you get lucky because of method conversion. IDOR, I told you, SQL injection, yes. In many cases, if there is an integer value or if there is a changing value in there, there is a possibility of getting not SQL, injection flaws. Authorization clause, yes, you can take that to enumeration or IDOR or authorization, those all comes into one picture. The last one, which is pretty important, which I found in a very big client when I was in a service-based company, they implemented a new product. They have their own IF token, which should expire in 20 minutes. And I found that the token is reusable, that token never expires. And all those test cases are documented in their document itself. So, the thing I want to say, if something is documented in a document, do not go for that. Dev people or the people who create those documentation, they can put anything. You have to use the test case for sure. Like, for that client, it was mentioned that this IF token will expire in 20 minutes. You cannot reuse the IF token and everything. And I found like 4 or 5 critical IF token related bugs in that guy. So, definitely do not go by the looks. Try your test cases. There is a different in approach by a service based or when you are performing REST API for a client or when you are performing in-house. The approach, why I am saying different is, for a client will provide you an endpoint, maybe documentation about that. Client won't say that this web services are used in this particular different area. Like let's say there is a address change services there, right? That address change services can be used by many different functions. Let's say the mobile user is also using that, web user is using that, the mobile version of web is using that. So let's say you got a cross-site kind of, you are entering a payload and it is getting there somewhere. Means you are seeing it in the responses. But as this is a JSON response, the possibility is that it won't execute, right? REST APIs are JSON mostly.
Yep.
Yep. But you never know that the services which is using this particular address change services, that might render that page as HTML. So for a client, you cannot give that as a possible accesses, because for clients there is no possible thing. For clients, you have to show the exploit. But when you are an in-house guy, you have that idea. This particular services are used by 30 different modules and might used by 90 more in future. So you have to input, validate, and output encoding everything in the service layer. Or else the problem will happen that when you get a web application which use an address change in mobile user, let's say m.something.com in your site, and you find accesses there, and there is a possibility that this is happening because of the services, and you haven't input validated and output encoded that. If some web services in future will do the same, it will get executed there also, right? So for an in-house guy, you need to think of these kind of scenarios. What can happen? How many applications are consuming this particular service? And for a client, it's better, I will recommend that it's better to provide these kind of scenarios and give them the possibilities of injection and any kind of injection attack, so that in future, if they will consume that, they won't get victim of that particular vulnerability. Is it clear? Okay. So now it's time for the demo. This is a cool tool, WSSAP, which is automating the SOAP UI pen testing. Earlier, I never found a very good tool for SOAP UI automation or pen testing. What it does is, you just provide a WSDL file to it. It will fudge everything. It will do all the work and just give you the report. This tool has some this tool needs some more features, like giving a particular sample request and fudging from there, which is not there. You can contribute, and this just got released in Black Hat US this year. So definitely, if you are into SOAP services, check this tool. This is the other tool, Fudge API, which released in AppSec US 2 days back. The documentation is good, but I found it a bit difficult to run all the commands, so I have my own version of this. Fourth version, which have a better documentation, which I will merge in recently. This comes like you have to either set up it manually, or there is a Docker file present for this, which will do the work for you. HURL.tet, as I told you, this is an online application which give you all these things, how to do REST API pen testing, but not to go for this, because they will log everything in their logs. Hackathon, this is what the coolest thing, but the problem I faced here, I tried to set this up in four different types of machines and got unlucky. I emailed Dan, who is the CEO of this particular project.
When did you try?
Yes,
so the last 11 days, the build is broken.
half in the matrix.
It's not earlier issue on someone raised the issue and I face the same error. But I might have a VM where this is working.
Yeah.
If Riaz can find it, then it happens.
No, but I found a cool way of this because the APIs are there in public. Because with this website slash API, the API is exposed. So I thought of using that. The problem I faced is it asked for a basic authentication. I tried different usernames. I registered an account and tried that. It didn't work for me. So I mailed Dan, the CTO of NT Object, and unluckily he is out of office up to 18, so I'm waiting for his reply. When I will get a reply, I will write a blog post about this. Why I am much interested in Hackathon? Because the REST API documentation looks quite genuine and it has all the details how to perform a test and all kind of details which generally you get from a client, the documentation you get from a client or the documentation which I was talking about. So it has all the like what methods are used, what is the data, how to use the data, how to authenticate the service and everything. So this will be a best way to test web services, but unfortunately this is not available for now.
Also any Android app?
Yeah, I told already they have an Android app for web services testing. The documentation, if you currently want to install, the manual setup is here. The 6 number setup I turned into 14 and it is working great for me, so you can do the same. Now
so how does Fuzz API automate the testing?
What it does is 6 okay.
That I want to use. The first one is okay. This is API Fuzzer based on which Lalita and Avijit wrote for JPI. This is the for JPI. You can mark down this, or you want me to zoom? Let me zoom it. This tool is used for automating APIs fuzzing. This has a cool interface like this, and this will give you results something like this. It will also show the scan history. You have two kinds of setups. One is the normal one or the manual one, and the other one is using Docker. I tried the manual ones and it works great for me. I just changed some of the documentation which is mentioned here. See, like this. The documentation I have changed based on what I felt or the problems I faced. So you don't have to face the problem. After this, I want to show you one more tool which I am gonna use, that is REST Client. And this is a Mozilla add-on. I will use this one for testing. Definitely Foxy proxy is needed to switch your normal traffic to a interception proxy, and the interception proxy I'm using is Burp free edition. As you can see, this is a free edition. My Burp is running on .0.0.1 in 8080 port, and I had clicked on the to intercept the responses. I have unchecked this so that I can intercept almost everything and see the responses. So these are the tools mostly we will use. And the first question is, what we are going to test? There are two test sites. One is DWS, Damn Vulnerable Web Services, and the other one is Mutilday. So let's start with this one. Here is a interface. As you can see, this is the URL for which we are going to use. Okay, this URL is vulnerable to SQL injection, as it is clearly shown here. So without wasting much time, let's do the manual thing first. Let's copy this. Let's open the REST client for us. Paste it. I think now it is visible. As it is shown that method is used get. So let's send the request and check the response. Cool, we got, yep, the results, the username and the signature. So now we can test it here. It will be like repeater of a burp. You can do many different things here, like if you change the request, what will happen? It provides exception saying that post parameter something is required. So we can always test it here using REST client, or we can send this request to burp and try to do all the fudging from there. And to do that, I need to set my proxy use burp for our URLs. So let's set the request again. Okay, forgot to on the interception. Let's do it again. So we got this request here. What we need to do now? Send it to repeater. Okay, so we are getting this result. Apart from that, we are getting header requests like what X powered by and server and version disclosures are there. We can take that from here. As we know, this parameter is vulnerable to SQL injection. So let's try the single quote. What error are we getting? Cool. We are getting a part disclosure, and we are knowing that this is MySQL and other things are. So this is quite cool. We can use this, and now we are pretty much sure that we found this vulnerability SQL injection here. And to exploit that, we can definitely put it into the SQL map and check. So we will test that after some time. For now, let's do this using a wildcard character, whether it is taking that. Okay, cool, we are getting all the usernames and details. So what we can do, we can keep that these things as our findings, and we can use it in future. Like let's say I need to brute force something, and I know all these usernames, and I can put that and check whether rate limiting is implemented or account lockout is implemented or not. So for many different things, as we earlier know that web services generally probe for mass enumeration, and we are able to enumerate many more data which can be later used for a critical attack. So we will do the same. So this is how you can test a web services using REST client and burp. Now taking this to another level, we won't directly put it in SQL web because this do not look like a web REST structure. This generally looks like a get request with a parameter and a value. So we'll try to check the DBWS one. And furthermore, we can use this URL for Fudge API. So this is the Fudge API. After installing, you need to start three different tabs. Yeah, these are the four tabs. As you can see, one here my Redis server is running, here my Sidekick is running, here my Rails server is running. As you can see from the documentation I have written, see, you have three tabs. You have to open these three tabs with these commands so that your Fudge API app will up. Once it is up, you need to sign up. You can put anything. Let me put fudgeapi.com, a email ID and a password, and confirm the password. Cool. So this is how the interface looks like, and we will use the same utility thing as endpoint, and we will show the which method is used. Definitely this is a get method which is used, and this is the thing and parameter we can, and it's part of get, so we do not need to specify the parameter differently, because we can see it quite, it is the part of the URL or the endpoint. So let's trigger the scan. Let me close this. It might take much time for me. Okay, now we started a scan using Fudge API, and it will take some time to show us the result. So not to bother about that, it is working on results. Let's quickly jump to some other part, like the DBWS. Here there is a challenge of REST API SQL injection. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Let me open this directly in So this is a typical REST endpoint URL looks like. Generally the REST endpoints look like this. So as we can see, we can enumerate users from here. Yeah. As we can see, this is the part of resource and part of URL. This part is vulnerable. This part is dynamic, and when a parameter value is dynamic, as we know, we can definitely try it for injection vulnerability. So let's try for SQL injection. Yeah, we are getting a DB error. So what can we do now? We can do one thing. We can take this URL and run it with SQL map. Yep. So now let's run the SQL map. -u is the switch for the URL. So how to give SQL map so that the SQL map will fudge the parameter in this particular part one. So there is a thing called custom based injection in SQL map. So we need to provide a wildcard character there so that SQL map will take that as a parameter as the fudging parameter, and SQL map will try different payloads there. So in REST API, let's say this parameter is vulnerable, not the last one. Then also we can put asterisk here and the original value here, and SQL map will run the same and give the result if the parameter is vulnerable. So this is quite easy. We can use custom based injection using SQL map by putting wildcard character in the REST API to test SQL injection. Let's start. Custom injection marking character found. Do you want to process it? Yes, we definitely want to process it. It looks like the backend DBMS is MySQL. Yes, we want to skip other scans. Do you want to include all tests of MySQL? Yes, we want to include all the tests. This is trying different tests, don't worry. We'll check the other one now. It will take some time. Okay, the REST API, fudge API scan is completed. As you can see, it found one low, two, and two high. And definitely it found SQL injection and IDO for us. As we can see, this is quite easy. You just need to put an endpoint here and specify the method. If you know the parameters, put the parameters. If you don't, just leave it like that, and the fudge API will do its work for you. It will give you a cool graph as well as a detailed bug table. And this will do the automation part for you. Now let's again go to the SQL map part. So it came like the parameter is vulnerable. Do you want to keep testing further? No, we don't want. And as we can see, so this is part of URI. This is error based, time based blend, union query, technology, backend data information, and everything. We got everything. So if you want to do more using SQL map, you can do that. But basically our approach is how to pen test a REST API with different tools. And what we learned with two test beds, Mutilde and DBWS, and we learned how to use REST client in Mozilla, how to integrate that with Burp to fudge different parameters, how to use fudge API, and how to use SQL map for that. So this is all about the demo. Hope you like it.
Okay, any question that Nation wants to know? No. No?
When do we do Hamla?
You can do anything. The research I did in last 15 days, we can anytime. Matter being the hackathon, if I will able to set up that hackathon, then the Hamla will be in different level. Yeah, you help me with hackathon setup, I will do that. No problem. Okay, no questions, I think. Then these are the references which are not in the slides. I got like 20-25 references, so I put some of them in the slides in the appropriate places, so you don't need to go to the reference page, because I know no one goes to a reference page and check the reference page, right? So it is all there. If you have any questions, you can ask me. If you want to set up Fudge API, if those people are not active, you can ask me. By setting up in the Docker version and the manual version in two different Linux and Mac boxes, I can say I'm a pro in that now. So you can ask me. and that's all. Thank you.